This video was brought to you by the Powerbase Mini, a smaller, more compact alternative to the original Powerbase converter. Visit the link in the description for more information.
Skip it up and that up!
So this is always a touchy subject, because to me, it's a gray area. And that is delays. Game delays. A whole crap ton of games have been delayed this year. Evolve, Battlefield Hardline, The Division, Batman, Dragon Age Inquisition, Assassin's Creed Unity, The Order, and GTA 5 on PC. It's coming out early next year, and it's coming out for consoles, next-gen consoles, GTA 5 this November. And there's more games than that, but that's just a few prime examples there of games that have been delayed. And on top of all those delays, another big one from Sony has been Drive Club. It was actually going to be a launch title, a PS Plus free game, but now they're targeting October of this year. And Sony's UK Vice President and Managing Director, Fergal Guerra, explains why delays are a good thing. This is what he had to say. Personally, I think it's the right call. With games getting increasingly more astronomically expensive to produce, the cost of a misfire isn't just about disappointed gamers or sales, it's about the opportunity to sell on. If you've made a big investment and you bring it out half-ready for the wrong reasons, then there's going to be a cost. You're certainly not going to sell a second version of that new franchise you might be taking to market. It's not just about numbered sequels either anymore. As the landscape of gaming changes, additional content and longevity are overtaking iteration. A project like Destiny is a perfect example of how you can layer a 10-year roadmap, and it's peppered with discs and non-discs and digital content and a whole evolving landscape. See, it's funny, and I've been guilty of this too. When a game misses its launch date and they delay it, we all get pissed off, we all cry foul, and we're all angry that, hey, you know, this game has been delayed 10 times or whatever, and I really want to play it. Then you can't satisfy the consumer, because if the game comes out on time and it has bugs and has issues, we all cry and say, oh, why did you rush the game? Now it had, you know, this feature isn't working right. The online is glitchy. All you want to do is make a profit. So it's like either way, the developers and publishers don't win. They delay the game, people are pissed. They come out with the game on time and it has issues because it wasn't ready for prime time, people get pissed. So I'm in the boat where I rather have the game delayed and have the product work perfectly than have the game come out on time or even early and have it be half-baked and have features not working right. So look, if a game needs to be delayed multiple times, so be it. As long as when it comes out, it's working right. If a game's been delayed multiple times and it still plays and runs like shit and has a bunch of issues, then it's like, okay, what the hell were you doing? Then you still want to crucify the developer and publisher because they made you wait forever and they still delivered a half-assed product. But if it means, and they deliver, if it means that them delaying a game means it'll come out and run very well with minimal issues, then so be it, man. Let them delay the game. Let them delay whatever. Let them do whatever they have to. There's other games I could play. I have a life to live. I'd rather have the product come out and be perfect or close to perfect than get something half-assed just because they wanted to appease gamers. All right, folks, this is Rich of Review Tech USA. Make sure to rate, comment, favorite, and subscribe. And as always, thank you for supporting my channel. Have a good one. The preceding video was brought to you by Big Cheese's YouTube channel. For gameplay reviews, gaming music, and vlogs, subscribe to Big Cheese VG. Link below in the description.